In this video, I'm going to show you how you can change links around with the help of JavaScript and Google Tag Manager. This can be particularly useful if you want to pass on information on the URL to another website through the link. All and more coming up right after this. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and if you're new to the channel, we do marketing tech reviews, tutorials, and tips and tricks videos. So if you don't want to miss out, click that subscribe button, also that bell notification icon, so you don't miss out on new videos. Now, today we want to talk about how you can change and replace and attach something to a link via JavaScript and then also with Google Tag Manager. When would this be useful? Well, if you want to attach something to a string that wasn't in the original link, you can do so with Google Tag Manager. This is particularly useful if you want to pass on information that is outside of your website to a third-party tracking tool. So for example, to an affiliate program. You could attach an affiliate code to the link URL. You could also try to replace something in the URL, everything dynamically through Google Tag Manager. This can be super useful, and I'm gonna show you some cases in these videos. Now, the tutorials got a little longer than I expected, and that's why I broke them down. In this first video, we're gonna talk about how you can actually accomplish this with JavaScript. This is the underlying technique that we'll use in all the subsequent videos. So stay tuned for the second video, where I'm gonna introduce some use cases where you could be using the replace link functionality or the attach link functionality in future videos. We are particularly working here with affiliate links from Amazon, so it should be quite interesting for all of you affiliate marketers out there. Now, we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. Welcome back to our demo shop. On this page, we have certain links that we want to change around for our tracking purposes. Now, these links would be this buy product link. It takes you over to Amazon. We have three more links of these that we all want to change. Before we implement any kind of tracking into Google Tag Manager, we should try our JavaScript first so we know it's working correctly. Now, how would you change a link with the help of JavaScript? Let's try this out in our developer tools first. Inside of Chrome, you can go to your More Tools here and then your developer tools. This will normally open up the Elements pane, which will show you the HTML markup of your page. Now, we are interested in this buy product link, and we can utilize this tool here to hover over and click, and we'll see how it's marked up in our HTML. This is a pretty standard HTML link, ahref. In the ahref attribute, we have our URL that the user will be led to. Now, we want to select all these elements that have actually Amazon in them. How would we do that? Well, there's a handy command in JavaScript called document.querySelector, all. And then in parentheses, you would put in quotation marks, your CSS selector. So if you wanted to have all the div elements on the page, just put in div and we get all the elements on the page itself. The handy thing is, if we open this up with this little triangle here, we can hover over and see where these div elements are. Now, if you would try this out for links, we simply press the up arrow to get the last command back, and we can change the div into A. And we see all the links are now listed that are on this page, 77. And if we hover over them, we see here a logo, which would be this logo link up here. Now, this is obviously not the link that we are interested in changing. We want to get to the link that is actually on this product page. So we would narrow down our CSS selector. Let's press the up arrow again. And this time we only want to get links that have our URL inside of the href attribute. How would we accomplish this? Well, there's a modifier that we can implement, which would be two square brackets, and then the attribute that we're interested in our case, it would be href, the equal sign, and then in double quotation marks, we would put in how the href should be filled. In our particular case, I'm interested in this URL up here. Let's enter this in and press enter, and we only get one element back now, which is our buy product link. Now, obviously, we are also interested in the other Amazon links on this page. So we can modify this further to include links that have the Amazon in their URL, kind of like a contains option. And the modifier for this is the asterisk in front of the equal sign. And then you just have to put in your contains match. In our case, it would be simply Amazon. And voila, we have all the three links that have Amazon in their URL selected. Now going forward, we can utilize this link, but let's jump back to our first query selector here, just so we can see how we can change one link first before we change all of the other links. So here we are back to our one link, and exactly that link we want to change. Now changing links involves getting to the actual attribute of href to change out this URL. How can we select the attribute with JavaScript? Let's go back here. And there's another command, we just need to change them with a dot. Then we enter get attribute. And again in parentheses and quotation marks, we put our desired attribute. In our case, that would be href. Whoops, since we have a node list here, we actually need to select the node first. This would be the first node. In our case, it would be 0. And then we can get the attribute with the href command. Okay, and here we get our link back that is tied to this HTML element. Now, if you wanted to change this, there's another command. We don't want to get this attribute, but we want to set or change this attribute. So we'll change this to set attribute. And now we can utilize the href. This is what we want to change and put in a new value. Let's just put in test. Now this gives us back undefined, but what actually happens under the hood, if you go back to the elements pane here, we see that our href has changed to simply test. And if you click this button, we would go to our own page with the test attached, which doesn't really exist. Now, this doesn't make much sense, but this would be the technique to actually change around a particular link. The set attribute would be set to the href and the link that you want to have in here. So if you wanted to make a better example, we would, for example, say, let's send this user to Measure School. And if the user now clicks on this file link, he goes to measureschool.com. And so we have now changed this link around. This obviously only happens if we execute this command before the user clicks the link. Now be aware, this only happens if the user would click this link. It doesn't happen right now for the other links. For this, we would actually need to loop through our results. Now for this, we need to write a little bit more code. That's why I'm going to go over to the sources panel where we can open up our snippets. You can find them right here. You can write your own snippets. So I'm going to open up a new snippet here, and I have something prepared here already. In this command, we utilize again our query selector and get all the Amazon links. We save them in a variable called links, and then we iterate over these links and set the attribute to measureschool.com like we did before, but this now happens for all the links. You can press this button right here. It will execute and open up the developer tools. As we expect, it returns undefined, but now all the links up here are changed to measureschool.com. If we inspect them, right here, we see they're all changed to measureschool.com. Now, this is how you can change all links on your webpage with the help of Google Tag Manager. In the next lesson, we're going to go through some use cases where we change links around, attach stuff to links, and make your tracking better through this technique.